Hi guys, this is Kim again. I hope everybody's having a wonderful day. I'm having a wonderful day so far. excuse me. I just wanted to talk to you guys today. I'm really excited because I'm gonna start the trust series that I was talking to you guys about. And the first thing that I wanted to talk about is where the distrust comes from. That's what I wanna get into a little bit today. And the definition of trust is belief that someone or something is reliable, good, honest, effective, etc. That's where we should be, but most of us is in the distrust area, and that's the lack of trust or confidence, a feeling that someone or something is not honest and cannot be trusted. That's where a lot of us are. And what I want to touch on today is exactly where that stems from. Because in my discovery and going through the processes that I've been going through, trying to get to a happy place in my life and understanding who I'm supposed to be in the world, I've examined this a lot because it's something that I've felt over the years. And I've never, you know, took the time to examine it until I had this time in my life where I hit a wall and I had to like figure out what was actually going on with me. And trust is the foundation of all human relationships, human connections. And when we distrust, those connections are broken. And where mine started out, and I know people talk about their childhood and all this other stuff, but that's where mine came from. And, you know, I grew up in a household where there was a lot of chaos. Both of my parents were alcoholics. One of my parents was mentally ill. And that created a lot of instability. I had times where I had to, you know, live with my grandmother because of things that were going on. And at that time, when I did have to do that, that's when the opportunity for the person who sexually molested, that's when that started. And I mean, I'm a child. I don't know, you know, what's going on, but these are the things that I experienced. And after, you know, going through a lot of things that I've gone through, I felt unsafe. I didn't feel protected. I had times in my life where there was like an aching in my stomach because I felt unloved, and I felt, you know, I just felt like this sense of sadness a lot. I felt that a lot. And, you know, it just created this cycle of depression that I found out as I got older that I had been fighting all of my life. I mean, I even had incidents where I was cutting myself and I didn't even know why I was doing that. So that's where my distrust started. You know, I never really heard my mother tell me that she loved me. You know, I understood what was going on with her as I got older, but when you're a child, these are the things that develop your personality. It develops your well-being, how you feel about yourself, that kind of thing. And I felt, I mean, there were times when I felt like I didn't want to be here any longer. Even when I was 15, I actually tried to take my life. You know, and I, you know, this is where, you know, all of this, you know, the distrust happened. I didn't trust people. I didn't trust men. I've had like very unhealthy relationships with men because of my trust issues. And it has just created, I became isolated because I didn't trust people. I didn't connect with a lot of people because I didn't trust people. And it just, created this cycle in my life where I was like, on the outside, everything looked great. I mean, everything looked great. I mean, you know, I took care of myself, you know, my hair, you know, my nails, skin, all of that. I went to school, I did all of this stuff, but on the inside, I was somebody that was screaming out for help. And I didn't trust anybody. I didn't trust family members. I didn't trust anybody. And until recently, you know, that was the case. I will say within the last 5 years, I've been discovering what has been going on with me. And my trust issues run deep because, you know, of things that happened to me, I didn't feel safe around the people that I felt were supposed to love and protect me and take care of me. I didn't feel safe around them. So this is what I'm saying. You have to find out so that you can work it out. You have to find out where the distrust began so that you can work on that. Because you're never going to be able to trust people if you don't find out exactly where it stems from. If you're having feelings of distrust, if you're having feelings of, you know, sadness, and you're not understanding where that comes from, this is the time where you need to examine it and find out exactly where it comes from. And this is the way that I wanted to start the series, because I want us to find out exactly where the distrust comes from, because a lot of people are feeling this. They don't trust people. But do you know the reasons why you don't trust? And that's where you got to get to. So that's my lesson for you guys today. Actually, that's your homework. Find out, look within yourself and find out and examine, why don't I trust people? Where does that come from? And I know people are always talking about we blame our parents and we blame our childhood. But these are our first, this is where, we're not born with distrust. We're not born with that. It comes from somewhere. And these are the people that are raising you and they're teaching you. So you have to look at the people that were around you that helped develop your feelings and your, you know, your feelings of well-being, your feelings of, if you know, you have feelings of not being well taken care of and that kind of thing. You have to examine that. And you're not trying to blame anybody. Sometimes you can look at where the person was. I mean, my parents were alcoholics. And, you know, one of my parents was mentally ill. I can't blame her for that. That's just, you know, the way it was. But because I was affected by it, it's up to me to fix what happened to me. So it is what it is, and we just have to deal with what happened to us. So this is where I want you guys to start. I love you so much. I really want you to get to a happy place. I want you to, you know, start trusting. And, you know, because when you're trusting, you're more open. You're more open to new experiences and that kind of thing. So take that today, guys. I love you again. And have a wonderful day. And always, always love yourself. I'll talk to you guys on the other side. Thank you so much. Bye.